Welcome to Study with the Best, the magazine show about CUNY. I'm Duane.
And I'm Vespina. With 1 in 8 women being diagnosed with breast cancer during their lifetimes, many people at CUNY have been affected by it, whether themselves personally, a family member, or someone they know and love. On this edition of Study with the Best, we'll join CUNY staff, students, faculty, and alumni as they raise awareness about cancer at the American Cancer Society's Making Strides Against Breast Cancer Walk.
We'll hear from CUNY graduates who are bilingual about the huge opportunity to become a New York State Court interpreter today.
We'll meet a PhD in musicology from the CUNY Graduate Center who has quite a range.
And our own Crystal Lowe explains how you might qualify for a free education at one of CUNY's community colleges. So, stay tuned.
The American Cancer Society's Making Strides Against Breast Cancer takes place in Central Park every year in October during Breast Cancer Awareness Month. Teams from many of the CUNY campuses join in with the tens of thousands of people who walk and raise money for breast cancer research and support services. Although it was raining the day we were there, it didn't dampen the spirit or the commitment of our students, staff, faculty, and alumni who turned out.
Let's make strides against breast cancer in 2009. Join me in the countdown. 10,
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's
go!
Some of us here today feel a special connection to this. Some of us have, you know, family members that are survivors of breast cancer, other types of cancer.
I have a friend actually whose mother is going through breast cancer right now. She's having the chemotherapy, and it's when I see my friend cry, like, that made me want to go here even more.
For the past month, because I'm at school, I've been walking around with this. I wear this, like, normally like this, and it's like, I'm not the kind of person that'll wear a pink shirt. Like, I won't be covered head to toe in pink, because I just don't do that. But even this, you know, in this press, I've had people, like, friends to me, that's kind of girly. I'm like, why is it? You see the ribbon. This is not about me. That's nothing to do with me. You know, but if I can draw attention, if I could, for a second, you could look at me and ask me why. Why do you have that ribbon? Why are you walking? Then you know what? I know I made a point.
Oh, no, let him go.
This is my third year doing the walk for breast cancer. We lost a very close staff member, Barbara Cochran, to breast cancer. She was the one that inspired me and encouraged me to do the walk. I'm going to be walking until this old body stops.
Go Barbara! Go Barbara! Go Barbara!
Go Barbara! Go Barbara!
I think we've had at least 15 to 16 schools here, from the community colleges to senior colleges all over.
Making strides against breast cancer is an experience. You come here, our breast cancer survivors are our celebrities. We love them. We do this for them. We want them to have more birthdays with us.
I'm here today because I volunteer every year at the Survivors Tent for Breast Cancer Walk, and I am known as Gail the Hugger. I give every survivor that walks into this tent a hug after they receive their t-shirt and their ribbons and all the other things that they get. A hug is probably the most important thing they get in this tent.
I was diagnosed the first time in 1994 when I was 37 years old. I had stage 2 ductal carcinoma. So now I'm cancer-free, I'm a 15-year survivor, two-time survivor, and I just started doing art that is connected with breast cancer awareness, because I want to spread the message, especially in the African American community, because there is such a high disparity rate of mortality due to breast cancer. I'm just so happy to be here and share my art with people and talk about early detection and survivorship and advocacy and all that good stuff. And especially that you're from CUNY. I'm a Hunter graduate, and I'm so proud of my school, and I want to give a shout out to Hunter. It's raining like crazy, but it's liquid sunshine, and we're having a great time anyway.
Happy to be here from Venezuela.
Nice. I think it's important that the students and faculty and staff understand that there are big causes out there that we can do something about. And by taking an active role in these kinds of events, raising money for the cause, we can make a positive impact on someday making sure that nobody has to hear the words, "You have cancer."
There's a growing need for court interpreters throughout the New York State Unified Court System. If you are fluent in English and speak another language, including sign language, this may be a good career for you. We'll speak with some CUNY graduates on why they enjoy their work so much and how to become a New York State court interpreter.
All right.
I understand you require the services of an interpreter, is that correct?
Buenos dias, señor.
Everyone has a right to express themselves in court for whatever the case is about, whatever the situation might be. And with court interpreters, we make that possible. People don't seem to realize that you don't necessarily need to speak English in order to have your day in court. That's what interpreters are there to do.
When did your husband move out?
7 months ago.
Has he visited the children since he left?
Yes, he came over the day after Thanksgiving and New Year's Day. There's a huge opportunity right now for people that speak another language, or fluent in sign language, because since we provide interpreters in any language, we need to have people that are proficient in Arabic, in Albanian, in French, Bengali, anything from A to Z for all of the courts in New York State. So there are opportunities if you're interested in full-time positions, if you're interested in part-time, if you're interested in freelancing, or even one day a week, even just for the summertime, there are opportunities.
After I graduated from Hunter College in theater and film, I did various odd jobs and worked in acting, and my mother was already a court interpreter in the system, and she suggested I take the court interpretation exam. Which I did, and I passed, and I became a freelance interpreter.
Diagnosis and treatment: inflammation of the carotid, high arterial pressure.
Diagnóstico y tratamiento: inflamación de la carótida, presión arterial elevada.
It's a job that really stimulates you, your mind, because you're constantly updating your vocabulary, you're constantly interacting with people from different cultures.
It's very rewarding, and at the same time, it's never boring. You just never know what a typical day, there is no typical day. You never know what kind of a day you're going to have in terms of cases.
You could be helping people, like I say, fill out an application, and you could be in the middle of a trial the next hour, and then you could be in a hearing the next trial. So it's unpredictable.
Well, the minimum requirements in order to begin the whole process and be an interpreter is to be a high school graduate and know a foreign language, and then you qualify to take the exam. You should be comfortable in having a conversation, being able to interpret newscasts, let's say news reports in both languages. And once you've passed our exams, your name automatically becomes part of our statewide roster. And you would be able to tell us in what parts of the city you're available for assignments, what parts of the state you might be available for assignments, and the courts would call you whenever they need someone in the language under which you're listed. Hunter College offers two programs. One is in the Romance Languages Department, where one could get a BA degree in Spanish English interpretation and translation. And they also offer a certificate program in the School of Continuing Education where you could get a certificate in Spanish English interpretation and translation. It's great that CUNY offers these programs because it's responding to the growing demand of interpreters in the legal field as well as in the medical and business industries. Our salary currently is roughly $50,000 a year to begin with and has a full benefit package. We also have the per diem rate. And at this point, it's $250 for a full day assignment or $140 for a half day assignment.
You get the satisfaction from helping people. You are helping people to communicate, to understand the proceedings that are occurring. And they would not be able to if not for you. And the court personnel would not be able to communicate with them either unless you are present. So what you do is vital.
So if you are a people person and you like to talk, there's a place for you in the court system as a court interpreter, definitely. It's a lot of fun.
I would encourage anyone interested in a career in court interpreting to visit our website at www.nycourts.gov/courtinterpreter.
Still up on Study with the Best, how rock and Baroque music come together.
And Study with the Best's Crystal Lowe at Borough of Manhattan Community College, coming up ASAP.
But first, this message from the Chancellor.
Hi, I'm Matthew Goldstein, the Chancellor of the City University of New York. Look who's teaching at CUNY, Michio Kaku, International Authority on Theoretical Physics, John Corleano, Academy Award and Pulitzer Prize winner in music, David Nassau, winner the Bancroft Prize for Best Biography, Jill Barganetti, recipient the Presidential Early Career Award for Scientists and Engineers, Gregory Rabassa, recipient the National Medal of Arts in 2006 from President Bush, Elizabeth Nunez, winner the American Book Award, Godfrey Gums, American Physical Society Fellow, Penny Andrews, recipient the Woman of South Africa Achievement Award, Isaac Goldenberg, awarded the Orden de Don Quixote 2005. World-class talent, award-winning scholars, CUNY is their classroom, CUNY is your university.
A songwriter and classically trained soprano, Brooke Bryan's performances range from Renaissance to rock music. Now, this PhD in musicology from the CUNY Graduate Center has made it a point to utilize music as a means to help others. Let's listen in.
My name is Brooke Bryant. I have a PhD in the music department here at the CUNY Graduate Center. I'm an adjunct professor at a couple of different universities in New York, teaching music history classes. I'm also a musician, singer-songwriter, and I play with a band.
Take the pieces of my soul, bind them gently, sew them slow.
And I also am the artistic director and a singer in Carites, which is a trio performing Baroque music in and around New York City. It's three girls, and Carites is the word for graces in ancient Greek, so we fashion ourselves after the graces of Greek mythology, wearing costumes and doing a lot of Greek-inspired gesture. The singing styles that you have to use for both rock and Baroque music are very different. The Baroque style is a very classical style, so it's classical operatic singing. The music works with very strong emotions, strong contrasts of emotions. So even though it's written a lot earlier than most stuff you would hear on the classical music stage, it's very theatrical. There's a lot of room for the body, a lot of room for acting, for performance. Rock and roll singing is it's rawer, it's grittier. I usually sing in a lower range of my voice than I do in the Baroque music. But again, even though the timbre of the voice is different in each, there's still a theatricality about both kinds of music that is similar.
Shall we wander into the void or wait here?
I teach voice classes at Daniels Music Foundation, which is a nonprofit offering free music classes to people with disabilities in New York, both mental and physical. It's the idea of music as something that changes people. The idea of music is something that gives people a reason to wake up in the morning, gives people something to look forward to. Music is a way of building a community. I created an organization called Women Artists Rock, or WAR. WAR is an organization that is founded on the idea that art and music can change people's ideas or change people's way of thinking about things. Really interesting sort of synthesis of the law enforcement side and the artistic side, and the idea that these two things can work together to move people to want to change their minds about an issue and actually to do something about an issue. My goals change by the day, and they change all the time. I used to think that you had to be, you know, a platinum selling artist to make it in the music world, but now I've seen that there are a lot of different ways to make it, and if you're making music that you care about and that you have creative freedom, it's the best, it's making it, and it's a way to be happy.
I am hungry for a change. You are thirsty for the that soon we'll be home among the ashes left when the wars are overthrown.
How'd you like to earn an associate's degree from a CUNY community college in under 3 years with free tuition, free textbooks, free MetroCard, free mentoring and job placement, everything free, free, free? Have you got your attention? Here's Crystal Lowe.
Ask anybody what ASAP means, and they'll tell you as soon as possible. But at the six community colleges of CUNY, it also means
the accelerated study and associate programs. We enroll students in select majors, and we support them so that they can study full-time and complete their associate's degree within 3 years. The national three-year graduation rate at an urban community college, like the colleges in CUNY, is only 16%. So in ASAP, we set ourselves what appeared to be an impossible task, that we would graduate 50% of the students that started with us within 3 years.
Mr. Mayor, I'm privileged to stand in front of you today and say that these hardworking students, the wonderful faculty, the support staff, your significant contributions has enabled us to announce today a 53% graduation rate.
When we first launched this program 3 years ago, we hoped about 50% would graduate. 53% is wonderful. Even 50% would have been a remarkable feat. We all know that studying is hard, particularly if you have to raise a family or hold a job at the same time, and many of our ASAP students do exactly that.
You have five children. How do you find time to go to school?
To be honest with you, it's really, really
hard.
My oldest child, she'll go like, Mommy, have you studied for your exams? I said, oh, that's really, I appreciate that. She'll go like, she helped me to put the younger ones to sleep and say, go and study.
We're funded by the New York City Center for Economic Opportunity, so their mandate is to try to reduce poverty in the city of New York. So we target students who are from low to moderate income families for the program.
I come from a single parent household, so money is always like, you know, you're considering options for college, and college is skyrocketing right now, the expenses. And I thought that hearing about the program and knowing that they would cover your tuition and books, it seemed really good.
They explained to me that they would pay the rest of my tuition, plus they would pay for my books, which is a total godsend. And they would also give me a transit card, a metro card.
ASAP provides a comprehensive set of services. One of the key components is the advisement component. Every ASAP student has a dedicated advisor who works with them the entire time they're in the program. So their advisor is their lifeline. It's their personal mentor. And any student that's struggling academically in their classes, there's tutors always available to students to help them when they're struggling.
I speak to the career advisor a lot. You know, he sends me out on job interviews and stuff like that and give me tips and help with your resumes.
I have two children, and I quit school at a very early age. Thanks to the ASAP program, I was able to come back into the school, and they helped me with the test. They prepared me. The tutoring hours helped me because it made me strengthen my GPA. They showed me how to look for scholarships. They showed me how to look for the benefits, how to look for the help that I need.
I'm actually going to a four-year school now.
What four-year school are you going to go to?
College.
Lehman. And what are you going to take up there?
I'm doing the same thing, business.
Business?
I'm only missing one more year.
And what are you planning to do after that?
I'm planning to go on for my master's.
Now that I have graduated from BMCC, I am about to take another amazing step in my life. This is because of the many people who were there for me and programs like ASAP that helped a GED student get accepted into some of the top universities and colleges in the country. I'm going to Stanford in the fall, and I'm hoping to take creative writing, international relations, and have some art mixed in, specifically photography and art history.
I'm Dr. Bernard Pinari, representing LaGuardia Community College, ASAP, and we have two stars from ASAP, Pablo Pereira.
I'm a graduate student from the ASAP program at LaGuardia. Social sciences was my major, and I'm hoping to use that in the law enforcement.
Thank you. And Giselle Amador, our valedictorian of ASAP. Really happy.
Hi, I currently go to Queens College, and I'm a biology and English major, and I hope to become a doctor, specializing in gastroenterology.
This event to invite me, like, I feel so special right now. I feel like this is humble, and just to be in the same room as Michael Bloomberg, I hope some of his talent rubs off on me, you know? And I do hope I become a billionaire, but until then, I'm just going to try to help people and become a philanthropist.
Last year, we set an ambitious goal for our community colleges to graduate 120,000 New Yorkers by the year 2020. The ASAP program is one of the ways we are going to get there. The budget realities of this world are that we're going to have to find ways to do more with less, but that does not mean that we should walk away or have to walk away from any group of people that really need our help, particularly people like yourselves who are our future.
You're a philosophy student. What would Socrates say about the ASAP program?
Well, the obvious answer is the unexamined life is not worth living in. And CUNY allows, and this program in particular, allows you to have the time to examine your life.
For more information, contact
www.cuny.edu/ASAP or call us at 212-794-5773.
Call us ASAP!
Well, that's a wrap. Thanks for joining us, and we'll see you next week.
In the meantime, remember to study.
Study with the best.